This is Enough Said Sports.
Hey guys, I hope all is well in your world. It is all well here at Enough Said Sports as we come to you with another NFL preview and prediction video here on YouTube. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video and support us here on YouTube. Really appreciate that. As we get into a game that's going to be coming on Sunday, September the 26th, 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on CBS, it's going to be the Kansas City Chiefs going up against those Los Angeles Chargers there in Arrowhead. The spread for this one is the Chiefs are favored by 6.5, and the total is 55 total points. Starting with the L.A. Chargers, Brandon Staley 1-1 after last week's defeat to the Dallas Cowboys 20-17. That was a very, very tough defeat. We'll get into that here in just a minute. Quarterback Justin Herbert, unbelievable talent, can make all the throws, great arm, great everything, just not the absolute best decision maker at times. Pretty good offensive line for the most part for the Chargers. And of course, they have Joey Bosa on the defensive end of their defense. He is unbelievable, really, really great player. Looking back at the film, it was really hard to watch the film on this game against the Dallas Cowboys. Don't like blaming referees for losses. Don't like bringing them into the mix, but they certainly did affect this game. There was a couple calls there, namely the sack that wasn't a sack on Justin Herbert late in that ball game that forced the Chargers into a third and goal from the 26-yard line, forced them into a field goal, which set up the Dallas Cowboys and Dak Prescott, much to their credit, driving down the football field and kicking the field goal of their own to win the game. Greg Zuerlein deserves a lot of credit there, especially after struggling the week before. Good on the Cowboys' part. But mostly, the Chargers just shot themselves in the foot. Just too many penalties. They had multiple touchdowns called back in this game due to dumb, boneheaded penalties. And it just really, really killed their chances against the Dallas Cowboys in that contest. And like I said, the Cowboys deserve a lot of credit because they capitalized on it. They played relatively mistake-free football. Dallas did, and played well enough to win the game, deserved to win the game. And the Chargers really, again, shot themselves in the foot. I thought they did a similar thing against in week one against the Washington football team. But the Washington football team was just not as talented as the Dallas Cowboys. So the Washington football team could not make them pay. But I don't like what I'm seeing on film from this Los Angeles Chargers team. They seem to be very sloppy, very poorly coached. And I know this is Brandon Staley's very first year. Hopefully he can get this thing cleaned up. But so far, I'm not really impressed with the coaching job that he's done with all these different mistakes that these Chargers are making. Way, way too talented. They should be 2-0 and not 1-1. But hey, you know, they don't have anybody to blame but themselves, and they got to quit making these mistakes. On the other side, you got Andy Reid, also 1-1 for the Kansas City Chiefs. Lost 36-35 by the slimmest of margins to the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson. Patrick Mahomes, I don't need to say anything about his greatness. He is elite. I believe he's the most talented quarterback in the game right now, and he is an unbelievable talent. Offensive line-wise, they're young up front, but they've been battling valiantly. I think the play of Patrick Mahomes' sneaky mobility and them being gritty up front, they've done a nice job keeping Patrick Mahomes clean for the most part. And, of course, the biggest defensive piece they have is Chris Jones. Not that he was able to help them against those Baltimore Ravens that much last week. Looking at them on film, this is another team that really just gets on my nerves because of the way that they played defensively, because of the way that they took their foot off the gas against the Baltimore Ravens, and they shouldn't have done that. Clearly, their defense wasn't stopping anyone. So with that being said, they should have known that they needed to continue to score. And that's exactly the difference between this Kansas City Chiefs team and that team down in Tampa led by Tom Terrific, Tom Brady, when they were in a shootout with the Atlanta Falcons down there. It was 25-28 at one point in that game. And then Brady and the crew reels off 20 unanswered points. So they finished the job, and this Chiefs team doesn't finish the job. And with all that being said, guys, I don't trust either one of these teams at all with any kind of spread. I don't trust either one of these teams on the money line either, just because I know that if this Chargers team doesn't shoot themselves in the foot, they are probably a little bit better than this Kansas City Chiefs team, in my opinion, overall, because of the deficiencies on the defensive end for the Kansas City Chiefs. They probably have the worst defense in the NFL. And so with all that being said, guys, I love the total in this one. I like the over 55 points. I don't like anything else about this game, so I'll stick with the over 55 points in this one. And as always, guys, appreciate the support. Thank you so much for all that you do, watching the content, commenting. Appreciate that. Look forward to just continuing to interact and continuing to grow. So appreciate it. Talk to you soon. Take care of yourselves, and I will talk to you again really, really soon. Take care.